This is the instructional video for activity 8.2 parametric constraints, part number 2. Starting a new file, you're going to select standard IPT. When you begin this sketch, I'm going to draw this sketch on the XY plane. And initially, to do this, because it is all in parametrics, the first one is going to be an absolute value. So dimension number 0, the first one I'm going to draw, is going to start from the center of our XY coordinate, and it is going to draw straight up. This dimension is going to be 2 inches. I right-click OK. You can notice that if I go ahead and select on this dimension, you can see that it has the dimension value of D0 and the nominal value of 2. I'm going to continue this. I'm going to draw my line. And the next thing that I have to do is the top width. And that starts from the top and goes to the right. And this is also an absolute nominal value of 0.5. So that's dimension 1. The next one is going to be a line. And I'm going to draw a line that is vertical from the x-axis. And this one goes straight up, and it has the formula of D0. Divided by 2 minus 1/4, and I'm going to put 1/4 in parentheses. So this again is D0 divided by 2 minus 1/4, which turns out to be 1/4 inch less than half of the overall height. I'll press enter. And I'm just going to move this dimension off to the right here. My next is going to be the overall width. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select dimension, and I'm going to select my vertical line on the left and my vertical line on the right, and I need this distance to be 50% larger than the overall height. To get that, I'm going to do D0 multiplied using the asterisk key, which is Shift 8, D0 multiplied by 1.5, and that will get me 50% larger than the overall height. The next thing I'm going to do is take my line tool, and I'm going to connect the bottoms of those vertical lines, because I just did a dimension, I didn't draw a line. And now I'm going to connect the top width and the right height together. I'm going to press E on my keyboard. And I need the depth of this object to be 20.25 inches greater than the overall height. To get that, I'm going to type in D0 plus 0.25. And then if I select more, I want the taper to stay at 0, and it defaults at that. I'm going to select OK. Now I'm going to start a sketch on this top face, and I'm going to make 2 holes, and I'm going to start those holes off with circles. So I'm going to draw a circle on the top, and this first circle has an upper hole diameter that's 1/8 inch larger than the top width. To get that, I'm going to take V1 plus 1/8, and I like to put 1/8 in parentheses, so that does the correct order of operations. The next one is going to be the lower hole diameter, which is 1/16 less than the upper hole diameter. To get that, I'm going to do D6 minus 1/16 in parentheses. So I have these two circles on here, and what I'm going to do is apply a horizontal constraint so that these stay in the same line. So up here in my geometric constraints, I'm going to select horizontal constraint. I'm going to select the center of my upper hole and the center of my lower hole, and you'll see them link up and down vertically. The next thing I'm going to do is do the edge distance. The edge distance is from the bottom of my part to the edge of my circle. But what this is going to do when I press dimension is it's actually going to get me to the center of my circle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to include the radius in my equation. So this is going to be the longest equation that we write for this. And to do this, it is going to be D6 multiplied by 1/4 in parentheses plus 1/8 in parentheses plus D7 divided by 2. And that is going to get us an 1/8 inch greater than 1/4 of the upper hole diameter, including the radius of the lower hole. The next thing that we're going to do is do the dimension for hole center to center. So I'm going to select the top hole and the bottom hole, and I'm going to apply a parametric equation to that, and that is D3 divided by 2 minus 1/8 in parentheses. The next thing that I'm going to do is do the back edge to hole centers. To do this, it's referring to this edge on the right. So I'm going to click this edge on the right, and one of my circles, I'm going to go ahead and select the lower hole. And because they are constrained with this horizontal constraint, I only have to do it one time. And to do this, the back edge to the hole centers is 1/3 of the part depth. So I'm going to write D4 multiplied by 1/3 in parentheses. The next thing I'm going to do is an extrusion. So I'm going to select E on my keyboard, it's a shortcut for extrusion, and I'm going to select each of my profiles. I'm going to make sure that this is a cut extrusion. And the formula that I'm going to use is that both holes have a depth that is half the diameter of the lower hole. To get that, we're going to use an equation that is D7 divided by 2. I am then going to create the notch. To do the notch, I'm going to draw a new sketch on this front face. So I'm going to select Start Sketch, grab this front face, and I am going to draw a line. I'm going to select my line. I do not want to select it from this center point right here, because it's going to give me an error saying that I can't move it. But what I want to do is I just want to place a line on my x-axis on the bottom here. And what I'm doing is I'm preparing it for the notch width. The notch width is 35% of the overall width. So to do this, we're going to do D3 multiplied by 0.35 in parentheses. So I have my notch width on here. The next thing that it tells me is that the notch is centered in the front face from left to right. So what I'm going to do is apply a coincident constraint. So I'm going to go up to the geometric constraints up here, and I'm going to select the one in the top left, and I'm going to grab the center point of the notch width that I just drew, and then I'm going to move my cursor, and I'm going to wait until I see the green dot that's indicating the center of the overall width. So I'm going to go ahead and select the center of that, and you should see your notch width now constrain itself to the center of the overall width. I'm going to use my line tool, and I'm going to draw a line that goes straight up until it touches the angle of my part. Then I'm going to do the same thing to the right side, making sure that these are vertical lines. And then I'm going to connect those lines together. The next thing I'm going to do is finish sketch, and I'm going to extrude this profile. I'm going to make sure that it is a cut extrusion, and the notch depth is a nominal value of 0.25. So there is no parametric equation. It will always stay at 0.25. Clicking the More tab, the taper is going to remain at 0. So we don't need to change that. The next thing that we're going to do is we are going to apply a fillet to the inside vertical edges of the notch. And they're going to be 1/4 inch of the top width. So we're going to select fillet. We're going to change our radius to be a quarter of the top width. To get that, our equation is D1 multiplied by 1/4 in parentheses. And I'm going to select the vertical edge here. And I don't even need to move my view. I'm able to grab it in this same view. And I have both vertical edges selected. I'm going to select OK. And lastly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip this view around so that I can see the bottom of my part. And I'm going to apply a shell to this. To apply a shell, what I'm going to do is change the thickness to half of the whole depth. So to get that, it is going to be D11 divided by 2. And I'm just going to select this bottom face, and you'll see the rest of it shelled out to half of the whole depth. If I go back to my home view, and I open up Manage, and then to the parameters, you should see now D0 through D17 in sequential order. You can move these around so that you get all of the formulas on one line. And this is your parametric for activity 8.2, parametric constraints, part 2.